Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to refine animations from Mixamo. I've got this golf character already set up in a golf scene. The character started as a Genesis 8 female from Daz Studio. I sculpted it into this stylized figure in Blender, then sent it back to Daz to add all the necessary clothing and accessories, and brought it back into Blender using the Rig GNS add-on, and then polished it up for this final look. It's fully rigged using the rigging buttons here in the Rig GNS tab, and is now ready for animation. Now I'm going to animate this character swinging a golf club using a Mixamo animation, and then show you how to refine it. First, I'll expand the Animixa tab. Under the Import section, I'll click Get, and then choose Get Mixamo. That opens my browser. Let me bring that into view and expand it. In the search box, I'll type Golf Drive. Let's preview one of the results on the character. I like this one, so I'll go ahead and download it. Set the skin to without skin, change the FPS to 24, then hit download. Back in Blender, I will go to Import Motion and choose Import Mixamo. I'll then select the Golf Drive animation from my Downloads folder and import that. Once it's imported, I can press Play to preview the animation on the Mixamo armature. Now I'll click the Bind button to retarget the animation of my character. You'll notice that when I click on Bind, the animation goes back to the Mixamo armature, meaning it hasn't been baked to the rig yet. So I'll click Bind again, then go ahead and click Bake Animation. I'll bake the entire frame range and click OK. Now the animation is baked and we can access it from this Action tab. I'll collapse that for now. Next, I want the character to hold a golf club. I've got clubs here on the golf cart. I'll select one of them. I'm going to move its origin to the handle where the character will grip it. I'll isolate the view, switch to edit mode, select the handle area, and move the 3D cursor to the selection. Back in object mode, I'll right-click the club and set its origin to the 3D cursor. Now I'll switch to global view, return to the rig, and go to frame 1. To move the club to the character's left hand, I'll place the 3D cursor on the palm, select the club, and choose selection to 3D cursor. Then I'll use the gizmo to position it properly in the hand. Now I'll select the rig, go to pose mode, select the left hand's FK bone to make it the active bone. Back in object mode, I'll select the club first, then the rig, and parent the club to the active bone. When I play the animation, the club follows the hand. Now let's adjust the right hand. I'll switch to pose mode, select any bone on the right hand, go to the kinematics tab in the panel, and enable right hand IK using this button. I want the IK bones to copy the FK bones on frame 1, so the hand is in the right pose for gripping. I'll set the end frame here to 1, then click IK to FK. Both the start and end frames are set to 1, I'll go ahead and click OK. Before positioning the hand, I'll enable auto keying and set the keying type to location and rotation. Then I'll move the right hand into position on the club. Now, with the right hand IK bone still selected, I'll add a child of constraint in the Bone Constraints tab. Set the target to the rig and search for the left hand FK bone as the parent. Now, when we play the animation, the right hand follows along with the left. I'll return to frame 1 and switch to side view. In the Adjustment tab, I'll select Arm Lower, and set the axis to X and disable the right side and then tilt the left arm to move the club closer to where the golf ball would be. Now in front view, I'll adjust the arm upper, disabling the right side again, and give it a slight tilt on the Z axis. I'll also adjust the abdomen, set the axis to Y, and tilt it as well. Okay, let's preview that. To make the swing more meaningful, I'll add a golf ball for reference. I'll go to Object Mode, place the 3D cursor here, add a UV sphere, scale it down to golf ball size, and move it up a bit. Now moving through the animation, I notice the club position is off on a certain frame. To fix it, I'll select the rig, go to Pose Mode, and in the Adjustment tab, select Arm Upper, Tilt on X-axis, disable the right side, enable current frame, and apply the adjustment. I'll also adjust the abdomen, set the axis to X, make sure current frame is enabled, and tilt it until it looks right. Back in object mode, let's play the animation again. This looks much better. I will pause that and return to the first frame. Now I'll zoom in on the right hand to fix some weird twisting in the arm. I'll switch to pose mode, select the upper arm IK bone, and scrub through the timeline to find any frames with deformation issues. There's one on frame 30, so with the upper arm bone still selected, I'll clear all keyframes for the bone so I can set new ones. So in the panel, I'll set the end frame to the last frame, then click Clear Frame, keeping both location and rotation, then click OK. Back at frame 1, I'll insert a new keyframe. Scrubbing through, I'll insert more as needed. There's an issue where the upper arm pokes into the chest. In the Adjustment tab, I'll select Shoulder, Enable Current Frame, Affect just the right shoulder, and Tilt on the X-axis. That looks okay. Scrubbing further, there are more frames where the arm is poking into the body. I'll turn off the overlays for a clearer view, go back a few frames to where the pose looks fine, and insert a keyframe there. Then I'll move to the frame with the poking issue and rotate the arm out of the chest. I'll rotate the arm again on this frame. I'll also tilt the shoulder again in the Adjustment tab. Not bad. The arm is raised a bit too much on this frame, so I'll rotate it down slightly. The animation is looking better. Now let's preview the result frame by frame using the arrow keys. But first, I'll turn off the gizmo for a clearer view. Satisfied with the correction on the hand, I'll now transfer the IK animation on the right hand to the FK bones. To do that, I'll re-enable the overlays, and with the upper arm FK bone as the active selection, I'll click FK to IK, leave the frame range set to cover the entire animation, and then click OK. Now we have corrections applied to the FK bones. Next, let's fix the feet. When I zoom in and play the animation, I can see the foot floating on certain frames. We'll fix that with the IK bones. Back at frame 1, I will select one of the right foot FK bone. In the Kinematics tab, I will then click IK to FK, have the full animation range, and then click OK. This might take a bit. Once done, I will do the same for the left foot. Okay, now when I return to the first frame and play the animation, we see the IK bones animating the legs just as the FK. Now I'll go back to frame 1 and start with the right foot IK. I'll scrub through the timeline to see how long the foot stays planted. I think we should hold it in place until frame 26. I'll collapse the Adjustment tab and then go to the Kinematics tab. I'll set the end frame to 26 and click this to return to frame 1, which has the pose I want to hold. I'll click the Hold Frame button, and with location and rotation enabled, I'll click OK. Now, scrubbing through the timeline, the foot stays planted up to around frame 26. Perfect. After that, it starts to lift. So I'll go back to frame 26 and set it as the start frame. Next, I'll select the toe IK bone, since it acts as the pivot point while the foot rotates on the ground. I'll set the hold range from frame 26 to the end of the animation. Then I'll return to frame 26, click Hold Frame, and hit OK. Let's preview the result. Now there's a new issue. The foot sinks through the ground. That starts around frame 35. I'll move the playhead to frame 40, quickly toggle the gizmo, and set the orientation to global. Then I'll raise the foot. Again, I'll select the toe bone, set the range from frame 40 to the end, click hold frame, then hit OK. That fixes the sinking from frame 40 onward, but before that, the foot still dips into the ground. So I'll set frame 39 as the end frame, then scrub back a few frames to where it looks fine. I'll set the start frame to 36. To remove the unwanted movement between frames 36 and 39, I'll click clear frame with location and rotation enabled, then hit OK. Actually, I think I should have started the clearing from frame 34 instead, so I'll adjust that, click clear frame again, and hit OK.
I believe the right leg looks good now. So let's also make corrections to the left foot. I'll return to the start and scrub through the timeline. I'll hold the foot until frame 27, so I'll set start to 1, end to 27, and jump back to frame 1. Before holding, I'll slightly lower the left foot to make sure it touches the ground properly. Then I'll click hold frame, and then OK. I'll preview that. I can see the leg starts pivoting around frame 27. So on that frame, I'll select the toe IK bone, set the start frame to 27, the end frame to the end of the animation, then click hold frame and OK. Now let's preview that. You can see the floating is gone. Let me zoom out and turn off the overlays for a clearer view. Animation looks much better. The arms are properly holding the golf club and the feet stay grounded. One last step. I'll transfer the foot corrections to the FK bones. First, I'll enable overlays, select a bone on the right leg, go to the panel, click FK to IK, set the full animation range, and click OK. Now the FK for the right leg is updated. I'll do the same for the left leg. Click FK to IK, then OK. Now when I play the animation, all the corrections are properly reflected on the FK bones. All right, that's it for this one. If you picked up something valuable, don't forget to hit that like button. It really helps more artists like you find this content. And if you're into rigging, animation, or working with DAZ characters in Blender, make sure to subscribe because there's plenty more coming. Now, if you haven't already grabbed the Rig GNS add-on, honestly, you're missing out. It's what powers everything I just showed you. You can get Rig GNS right now from Gumroad or Payhip. Links are in the description. Go check it out, and I'll catch you in the next one.